الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد آخر الأنبياء في الدنيا عصرا وأجلهم يوم القيامة شأنا وذكرا صلى الله وملائكته والصالحون من خلقه كما وحد الله وعرف به ودعا إليه أما بعد. I'm not used to doing a lecture standing up. So inshallah, if I move a lot, it's just I'm uncomfortable. The topic that I will be speaking about inshallah ta'ala is Fada'il al-Sham, the virtues of Sham in the Quran and the Sunnah. What does Sham actually mean to us? Does everyone here know what Sham is? We all know what Sham is, right? Sham is Syria, and what else? Palestine, hey? Lebanon, Jordan, hey? Parts of Turkey, even parts of Saudi Arabia. Tabuk and that land, all of it, they fall under Sham. So Sham is all of that land. So I'm talking about the virtue of that land. As an introduction, I wanted to bring to your attention, inshallah ta'ala, we know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is fa'alun lima yurid. Allah does whatever He wills, however He wills. La yus'alu amma yaf'alu wa hum yus'alun. No one can ask Allah what He does, why He does it. You can't question Allah. He's the one who does what He does. Walidhalik from His names is Aziz. Aziz means al-ghalibu fi amrihi. That things happen according to how He wants it. No one can stop it. That's what the name Aziz means. So what we realize is that Allah, from what He does and He wants to do, no one can stop it. As for you, you do things, it might happen, it may not happen. You might come with the effort and the hard work, it may happen, it may not happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to give particular lands on the earth virtue over others. فَعَالُ لِمَا يُرِيدُ. The one who does whatever he wills. And He chose to give Sham virtue over other lands, such as where I'm from, Somalia, originally. My country doesn't have the virtue that Sham has. Sham means more to me than my own country. Why? لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ فَضَّلَهُ. Allah gave it virtue, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what I want to bring to your attention as the first speaker, inshallah ta'ala, is you guys have to realize the value of this place. And what is taking place in Sham should really hurt you. The bloodshed and everything that's happening there. And this place that's getting torn apart, it should be something you feel. It should take away your sleep. You should cry about it when you remember your salah in the sujood. أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ لِرَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ. A time when you're the most closest to Allah, you're remembering those innocent people who are dying there and the land that's honorable. Both. It's got two things. So let's take some understanding regarding Sham. The first, inshallah ta'ala, virtue that I'm going to start with is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to Sham as a blessed land. Allah referred to it as blessed. He referred to it as blessed. And as Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 27th volume, page 44, he says, وَقَدْ دَلَّ الْقُرْآنُ الْعَظِيمُ عَلَىٰ بَرَكَةِ الشَّامِ فِي خَمْسِ آيَاتٍ. Five verses. Allah has shown that Sham is a land of barakah. And we'll understand what barakah means. I'll break it down for you, inshallah. First verse is the Surah Al-Isra. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. This verse Allah is talking about the night our messenger was ascended up, the night of Isra wal Mi'raj, which we all know in Islamic history. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken up high above. And this is where the salah was made obligatory, and the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he met other messengers. Sah? Where was the place in which the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to? Huh? Where was he taken from? Was Mecca, right? He left Mecca. And where did he go to? Al-Aqsa. Harrarahu Allah. May Allah free it. They was taken to what? Al-Aqsa. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was then taken up alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah refers to, look at it. He's talking about Baytul Maqdis, and he's talking about the lands that are close to it, which is what? Which is all Sham. Allah says, إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله. We place barakah in all of the surroundings of it. Allah said we gave it barakah. What is the barakah that's given? Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he's a scholar of tafsir. So he's going to explain to us what barakah means. What barakah was given to Sham. The barakah, he says, is لِسُكَانِهَا فِي مَعِيشِهِمْ. The residents that are there, their life was blessed. And inshallah, I'm going to touch more on it, what it means by how their lifestyle was good. They had good provisions and good lifestyle. Also, he goes on to say, وَحُرُوثِهِمْ وَغُرُوثِهِمْ. Their agriculture and their land, Allah blessed it for them. You guys all know the trips that the Meccan people used to have. What was it? رحلة الشتاء والصيف, right in the Quran. Where was that rihlak from? Where was it coming from and where was it going? Huh? It was between the Meccan and who? Sham. And inshallah ta'ala, later I'm going to touch on bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Our messenger never left Jaziratul Arab except to Sham. Our messenger. The only place he went to after leaving Jazirat Arabian Peninsula was to where? Was Sham. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. In the second ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَلُوطًا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا لِلْعَالِمِينَ. Referring to, again, Allah is using الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا, that which we place barakah over it. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari says, هِيَ أَرْضُ الشَّام. The verse Allah is here saying that the land we made barakah is Sham. And it's a view taken by Mujahid ibn Jabr, Hassan al-Basri, Qatadat ibn Da'amat al-Sudusi, and others. So it's a view prominent amongst the Salaf. Also, the third verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلِسُلَيْمَانَ الرِّيحَ عَاصِفَةً تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا. The land we place barakah over. Again, this is Sham, based on the opinion of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. He said, وَإِنَّمَا كَانَ تَجْرِي إِلَى أَرْضِ الشَّامِ الَّتِي فِيهَا مَمْلَكَةُ سُلَيْمَانَ. He said it's Sham because Sulaiman's kingdom was in Sham. Nabiullah Sulaiman. The fourth verse is in Surah Al-A'raf. Allah says, وَأَوْرَثْنَا الْقَوْمَ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا يُسْتَضْعَفُونَ مَشَارِقَ الْأَرْضِ وَمَغَارِبِهَا الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا. All of these times, Allah is using the same word, baraka, barakna, barakna, to emphasize to a Muslim that this place is not a normal place for us. The fifth verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ وَبَيْنَ الْقُرَى الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا قُرًا ظَاهِرَةً وَقَدَّرْنَا فِيهَا السَّيْرَ السِّيرَ إِلَى آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. Ibn Kathir says, Mujahid, Hassan al-Basri, Sa'id ibn Jubayr, Qatadat ibn Da'amat al-Sudusi, Dhahhak ibn Zayd, and others, they said, يَعْنِي قُرَى الشَّامِ. So from the first virtue that we learnt is, Sham is a land which is blessed. How is it blessed? In the lifestyle and the living that these people had. Inshallah ta'ala, the speaker later will touch more on it, that this land that Allah is saying, I gave barakah to it, how did it now become the situation that we see? One needs to ponder. One needs to analyze and look. Barakah and khair and good, not one time. Allah is saying it once, it's more than enough. Alaysa kadhalik, isn't that the case? But Allah chose it to say five times, repeat the same wording to show you how virtuous this place is. Also, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, made dua. And we all know the Prophet's dua is going to be accepted. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, in the hadith Imam al-Bukhari and Tirmidhi and Tabarani and others narrated it, and this is the wording of al-Tabarani, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, according to the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma barik lana, O Allah, place barakah over what? Fi shamina, for sham for us. Look at what the Prophet did. He said, "Fi shamina, our sham." Attributing it to who? To himself. And look, he started with sham. And inshallah, later we're going to look at the qawl of Imam Al-Qurtubi and Al-Izz ibn Abdus Salam, that the starting of a sham shows it's virtuous over all the others that he's going to mention. Allahumma barik fi yamanina, oh Allah, place barakah over Yemen. And we see the situation that's taking place in Yemen. So one would want to know how this changed. What had happened for them to lose this barakah and everything is important. Allahumma barik fi, the Prophet, second time he's saying again, Allahumma barik lana fi shamina, Allahumma barik fi yamanina, Allahumma barik lana fi shamina, Allahumma barik fi yamanina. Three times he said it. On the third time, the Sahabas, they said, or the fourth time, the narrator, he didn't know which it was, the third or fourth. He said that we said to the Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, wa fi Iraqina, add Iraq to it as well. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Inna biha al-zalazil, Iraq has earthquakes. Well, fitan, trials and tribulations are full of there. وَبِهَا يَطْلُعُ قَرْنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. And this is where the shaytan's horn comes from. The Prophet والسلام, he prophesied that for Iraq. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah commented on this hadith and look what he said, telling us what the barakah means. He says, وَالْبَرَكَةُ تَتَنَاوَلُ الْبَرَكَةَ فِي الدِّينِ وَالْبَرَكَةُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. The barakah that Sham has and the virtue that it has is barakah in its religion and barakah in its worldly affairs. And its worldly affairs as well. And it's in its religious. Those are the two things Allah has placed barakah over Asham. Same thing Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali says in his Lataiful Ma'arif. And of course I told you the statement of Al-Izz ibn Abdul Salam. He says that the Prophet started the dua with who? With what country? With what land? Asham. And he says the fact that he started with Asham, dalla ala tafdeel al-Shami ala al-Yaman. That Sham is more virtuous than Yemen. This is our messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. The second virtue, after speaking about the barakah that Sham has, is the angels are they protect and they look after Asham. As the messenger, salawatullahi wasalamu alayhi, told us. Based on the hadith, he says, when Zayd ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam had said, إِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ الرَّحْمَانِ اللَّهِ the angels, بَاصِطَةُ أَجْنِحَتَهَا عَلَيْهَا. The angels of Allah, they have their wings over Asham, protecting it. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said in another riwayah, يَا طُوبَى لِلشَّامِ يَا طُوبَى لِلشَّامِ يَا طُوبَى لِلشَّامِ. Meaning, the word طُوبَى means good life for the people of Sham. A good life for the people of Sham. A good life for the people of Asham. The third virtue that Sham has, based on the Quran and the Sunnah, is that Allah is pure people, the purest of people, the most honorable of people are from Sham. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala placed it on himself to protect Sham. تَكَفَّلَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكْ وَتَعَالَى بِحِفْظِهَا وَبِأَهْلِهَا and his people. Allah said, I'll protect them. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah's protection is with a condition. Allah protects you based on a condition. If you fulfill your part of the condition, Allah will fulfill his. But when a people break their side of the condition, then you can't question Allah for why he didn't do what he would have done if you were to follow the condition. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, based on the hadith of Ibn Hawala radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يَسِيرُ الْأَمْرُ the matter will head إِلَىٰ أَن تَكُونُ the matter will lead to, and it will head, and it will go on and on until what? Until there's going to be a junudan mujannada, jundun bishami, wa jundun bil yamani, wa jundun bil iraq. Look at the Prophet's prophesying something very powerful. The Prophet's actually telling us that the Muslim world is going to break up. He's telling us that there are going to be different leaders. Because why would he say an army in Yemen, and an army in Sham, and an army in this? When in reality the Muslim world only used to know what? A khalifa, one khalif who governs the whole Muslim world. Does that make sense? So from this the Mufassireen, Ibn Battal and others, they said what we take from this is what? وُقُوعُ الْفِتَنِ trials and tribulations will take place. وَتَقَاسِيمُ بِلَادِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ and the lands of the Muslims will be broken into parts and every different. إِلَىٰ أَجْنَاد armies each. Now pay attention to this particular hadith, the prophecies of the Prophet. And I'm not placing the Prophet's statement on a qadiyatu aynin, a specific scenario. I can't do that. We don't do that with the hadith of the fitan. We don't apply it on a particular scenario that requires it requires a divine law. But generally speaking, if you look at the situation, you see that happening and taking place. So what Ibn Hawala, the narrator who is the companion, he said to the Prophet, Ya Rasulallah, in adraktu dalik, if I reach a time where there is an army in Yemen and there is an army in Sham, which of those shall I be from? Khir li, he says. And khir li means ikhtar li, choose for me. Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah, choose for me in adraktu dhalika, if that time comes and I'm alive. So the Prophet said to him, Alayka bi Sham. Be part of the army of Sham. Be with the people of Sham. Fa innaha khiratullahi, because they are the elite people, they are the best of people. Min ardihi, from the people of the land that day. فَأَمَّا إِنْ أَبَيْتُمْ if you then refuse what I put forward, the Prophet saying, if you don't take that, you don't stick to the people of Sham, and you don't go for their army, you don't aid them. وَاسْخُوا مِنْ غُدْرِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ تَوَكَّلَ لِي بِالشَّامِ وَأَهْلِي. Then Allah has promised me that He's going to protect the people of Sham and its land. If you choose not to aid them and go and help them, Allah has promised subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will protect it and its people. So this sahabi was commanded by the Messenger alayhi salam to aid and support them. Salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. In another riwayah, Ahmad ibn Hanbal narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alayka bisham, upon you is Sham. Help those people, aid them, support them. Alayka bisham, help and support them. فَمَنْ أَبَى, anyone who refuses, فَلْيَلْحَقْ بِيَمَنِهِ, then stick with Yemen, help the people of Yemen then. So this shows us what? That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam specifically told us that the people of Yemen, people of Sham, with or without you, Allah is going to aid them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we say, Ya Rabb, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created the heavens and the earth, who owns everything in it, Allah, oh Allah, show us in Bashar and his regime, عجائب قدرتك, your power and your strength. اللهم احسم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم احدا. Oh Allah, count each and every one of his armies. Oh Allah, put a figure to it and I destroy each and every one of them. Allah can, we ask him to do that subhanahu wa ta'ala, to save those innocent people who are dying every single day. Abu Idris al-Khawlani, who's from the scholars who lived in Sham, he said, when he would narrate that hadith, he would say, مَنْ تَكَفَّلَ اللَّهُ بِهِ, anyone who Allah promises to aid them and help them and support them, فَلَا ضَيْعَةَ عَلَيْهِ, then there is no one who's going to come and destroy them. They're not going to be forsaken. Any people who Allah has placed on himself to protect them, then inshallah Allah will not forsake them. And inshallah Allah will not forsake the people of Sham. Allah will not. Allah will protect their honor for them. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will protect their blood for them. Allah will aid them. بِإِذْنِ الْكَرِيمِ. Ibrahim ibn Adham, he said, from Ata al-Khurasani radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, pay attention, this is the virtue of Sham. Ibrahim ibn Adham, he said, عن Ata ibn Yasar, Ata al-Khurasani, I said to him, لما هممت بالنقلتي. Ata al-Khurasani said, I wanted to move. I wanted to find a place where I can reside. I wanted somewhere where I can spend my life with my family and my children. شاورت بها من أهل العلم. And so I consulted the people of knowledge. I went to them and I said to them, I want a land to go to with my children and live there and grow and nurture myself. What advice can you guys give me? أين ترون أن أنزل العيالي? Where do you see that I should place my kids? Each and every one of them said, عليك بالشام, شام, go to Sham. So I said, I went, okay, ثم أتيت البصرة. And then I went to Basra, which is in Iraq. فشاورت من بها, so I consulted those who were in Basra. أين ترون أن أنزل العيال? Where should I take my children and where should I reside? فكلهم يقول لي, each and every one of them said to me, الشام, الشام, go Sham, stay reside in Sham. ثم أتيت الكوفة, and then I came to Kufa and I consulted the people of knowledge in Kufa and I asked them, أين ترون أن أنزل العيال? Where should I take my children? And each and every one of them said to me, عليك بالشام, upon you is Sham, stay there. ثم أتيت المدينة, and then I came to the city of Medina. فسألت من بها من أهل العلم. I asked the people of knowledge in Medina. And then I said, this is Medina, the city of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. I came and I asked him, أين ترون لي أن أنزل عيالي? Where should I take my children? Where should I reside? And they said to me, عليك بالشام, go to Sham. And they're the people of Medina. My beloved brothers and sisters, عامة الأنبياء, all these prophets, count them. All these prophets that I'm going to name, Ibrahim, Lut, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Yusuf, Musa, Harun, Yasa, Shu'aib, Yusha, Ayyub, Yunus, Ilyas, Dawood, Sulaiman, Isa, Zakariya, Yahya, alayhim as-salatu wassalam, all of them are min ardi Sham. They're all from that blessed land. Today you see fire litting from it, the bloodshed and those lands dust. All of these prophets were from there. Rather, the majority of the prophets were from there. As Ibn Rajab says, Ammatu anbiya'i bani Israel, the majority of the prophets of bani Israel, كانوا من الشام, they were from the land of Sham. This, and I said before, our messenger never left the Arabian Peninsula and never went to any other land except Sham. That's the only land he ever went to, alayhi salatu wasalam, with his uncle. Not only once, but twice. ولذلك الإمام ابن تيمية رحمه الله says فيها مبعث أنبياء بني إسرائيل وإليها هجرة إبراهيم وإليها مسر نبينا ومنها معراجه وبها ملكه وعمود دينه وكتابة وطائفة منصورة من أمته وإليها محشر والميعاد. Even the resurrection, the day of judgment, is going to happen in Sham. The gathering that everybody is going to gather together is going to be in Sham, where we all stand in front of Sham, nowhere else. When Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He. So this is what it was. This is the value and the. My time is short, so I'm going to conclude with this final virtue, which is the fourth, and I had up to 20 virtues of it. This one, and inshallah ta'ala, another final point. The other thing is this hadith, which really is something that a believer who believes the statement of the Prophet ﷺ to be haqq, a divine law, who believes it's true, when he hears this particular hadith, يَهْتَزُّ قَلْبُهُ, his heart will move. And he can't hold himself, but get emotional. And that is the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Qurrat ibn Iyas narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this companion. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا فَسَدَ أَهْلُ الشَّامَّ فَلَا خَيْرَ فِيكُمْ. If the people of Sham become corrupt and destroyed, then there's no khayr in you. If the people of Sham are fasad and corruption happens to them, then there is no khayr in you. This is something that the scholars of hadith took it very serious upon themselves to just sometimes even head a chapter based on this particular hadith. Ibn Hibban rahimahullah, for example, in his sahih, he chaptered a whole chapter and he called it ذِكْرُ الْأَخْبَارِ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْفَسَادَ إِذَا عَمَّ فِي الشَّامِ يَعُمُّ ذَلِكَ فِي سَائِلِ الْمُدُونِ. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, he said the chapter in it is the narrations pertaining to if corruption hits Sham, then it's going to hit all of the Muslim land. It's going to spread. The first one of the domino effect. If Sham falls, everything else will fall with it. So this can be taken as, since there's some Muslim lands who have still not fallen, then Sham is not corrupt yet. There's some khair still present in them, a bit of khair that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has given them. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. La shaka, there is harm. La shaka, there is problems that had happened from the people. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, with His divine wisdom, which you and I can never comprehend. And every single thing Allah does, there's always a wisdom behind it. I'll tell you a story of something that I remember. And this story helps me a lot because it shows me the issue of wisdom. Somalia, when Al-Shabaab and these groups were fighting and whatnot, and suicide bombings were being done. Alhamdulillah, things have slightly settled down now. I went a couple of years after all of that chaos, and I went there and I met a man. And so we were talking about the issue of if Allah wills something, it will always happen how He wills. Sometimes you may not know the wisdom behind why Allah did something to you. He might have taken a child from you, you think that's bad. But you don't really know if this child grew up, he could have been something bad, he could have caused you harm, he could have caused... His dying probably was a bigger, better than him to be alive. You wouldn't know that. You're just seeing the side that you've lost this child. So he told me a story which stuck with me, and it helped me in the course of my life to always remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's divine wisdom. What he told me was that he had a... He met a man who said to him, because he was a taxi driver. He was a taxi driver. So he said to the man said to him, can you drive me from this point to this point and I'll give you $100. Now the destination is very close and $100 is not that ride. It's too much. It's too much money. But he said, I got very excited and happy when he said that to me. So I said, no problem. $100, no problem. The only issue is I've got a little... No, so he said, He said, I brought him into the car. I drove him and I said, can we just step up? Can we pull over to the petrol station? And I'll put petrol into my car. So he put petrol into his car. And when he put petrol into his car, the man couldn't wait. So while he was busy with the petrol and everything, and paying off the petrol amount and everything, the man just got out of the car and left. So when he came back, all he saw was the man going into another car and just driving off. So in his heart, he just lost $100. So he said, I got angry. So he said, I took my car. I jumped into my car. I drove after this individual. And I was shouting at him, bring back the man you took from me. This is dhulm, you know, trying to get. So he said, what's happening is that the driving is that he's getting more, is getting distance, cars are getting between us, and it's getting longer and longer. And as the time went by, he said, the car exploded. Boom. He went to the scene to see what had happened, and he found out that the man was a suicide bomber. He was what? He said, Alhamdulillah, $100. I don't want it. I don't want the $100. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show me the wisdom? Huh? Now he knows. Now he knows why Allah chose him not to be the one who drives him. So brothers, everything has a wisdom. Everything Allah does. Sometimes you might know what it is, and sometimes you... وَلِذَلِكَ نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ مُوسَى when he came to the... and Khadir were together, and they were walking, and Khadir took the head of a child, and he killed the child. صح? What was Khadir looking at? What was he shown? He was shown that this child is going to live, and he's going to be a what? If Khadir never had told Musa this, what would he look like? A murderer, right? A cold... murderer, day, broad daylight, just killed a child, a kid. But Allah has wisdoms like that. When He does things, always say to yourself, قَدَّرُ اللَّهُ وَمَا شَاءَ فَعَلْ. Everything Allah wills, and He chooses to do it like that. So what's happening in this in Aleppo right now, and what's happening in Sham and everything? مِنْ قُدْرَةِ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. Allah is qudra. We don't question Allah's aid and rahmah and His mercy. We all surrender all of that to His what? His wisdom. I am just speaking from the angle of what's happening now. As for what led to it and what caused it, I will leave it for the brothers who are going to be speaking after me. My final point that I'm going to conclude with is, and there's a lot of points that I could have mentioned that I had, but I just wanted to mention, brothers and sisters, there are over 50 scholars that I have fit their names, and due to the time, and I want to be a person who follows the time, I only have a couple of seconds now left, is that there are over 50 scholars by name who I have here, who are all of them from Sham. They're the ulama of Sham, some of which you know and some which you may not know. From them, Ibn Kathir and Ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn Abdul Hadi and Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi and Sheikh Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani and others. All of those being ulama of Abdul Ghani, Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi, Ibn Qudam al-Maqdisi, Diya al-Maqdisi, all of these are from Sham. Even Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah, he was from Palestine, Gaza. Gaza today that's bombing, Imam Shafi'i was born there. And others, in large amount. So this place is something to all of us. So don't be heedless of it. Don't look at it as, wow, okay, another place, another Muslim land. It hurts you. And you need to play your role, my beloved brothers and sisters. If Allah has given you money and you have money, that you send that money towards the people who are there, their hunger and their food, You give that money. Wallahi. And also, you make dua for them. And you pray. And whenever you go to the sujood, and that's the closest time you are to Allah, you remember those brothers and sisters of yours who are now going through winter, who are dying because of the cold. Dying because of the cold. And the land. That you make dua for them. And Allah lifts up this from them. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that He lifts from the people of Sham the hardship that they are going through, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala destroys the enemy of Islam and the Muslimin. Allahumma arina fihim ajaiba qudratik. Oh Allah, show us in the people of Sham, Bashar and his army, a quick results. Allahumma arsim alayhim tayran ababil. Allah, send him from the sky rocks to destroy all of his armies, the babat, his battle, everything. Allah has the ability to do so. And this is something we need to do privately and we need to do it publicly. Every salah we pray, take that time out to specifically designate it for the people of Sham. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.